The edge is all the rage these days, and it kind of seems like every tech company out there is trying to find a way to tell their consumers so that they're on the bandwagon of edge computing. As with most of these buzzword tech inventions, the name doesn't really matter. What matters more is the concept behind it. Once you understand what they mean, you may even find that you're already using the edge or the fog in your day-to-day life, and it's really not that big of a deal. You may even find that this tech existed way before the fancy name. So if you put all the hype aside, what exactly is the edge? Putting all this boring technical stuff aside, the entirety of the whole edge and fog hype can be summed up like this. Edge computing is all about processing data in a geographically closer location before sending it back to a centralized location. That's it. So that's the end of my video. Good night, everybody. Nah, I'm just kidding. Let's discuss some examples of edge computing and where the term fog computing comes into all this. Like I mentioned a second ago in my super simplified definition, edge computing is really just the idea that computing doesn't need to be done in one centralized location and then sent or received to or from a network-connected device. The term edge computing started being used around the same time as the term content delivery network. But things have evolved since then, and the term edge computing has kind of separated from the term edge networking. Edge computing is now more associated with the Internet of Things. And these devices could be literally anything. Phones, cameras, sensors, household appliances, and vehicles are all things in IoT. Since all these things gather data and are expected to do something fun and exciting, they all need to either process information locally or send this information to capture to a server, which does some processing and then acts based on what it's computed. So with all these things out there, you can imagine that some of them need to react quickly or possibly process data that shouldn't be passed across the internet to a centralized server. To add to that, the centralized server is probably geographically far away from the thing, which adds additional problems with that whole quickly part. Edge computing aims to solve these issues, and the way it's solved is by processing data somewhere other than that faraway server somewhere up in the cloud. Here's a couple real-life examples of edge computing. Number one is Chick-fil-A. You know, the chicken fast food place? No matter what you think of their politics, Chick-fil-A has some pretty sweet networking and edge computing stuff going on. If you don't follow the Chick-fil-A Tech Medium publication, you are probably missing out on some pretty cool stuff. I'll leave a link in the description. They've built and shipped mini Kubernetes clusters to each of their locations to allow for local compute to happen at the store and then call back to home with the details. This is an excellent example of edge computing at its best. The second example is connected cars. I don't think that most people really consider it, but your car is probably an edge compute node all on its own. For some more technologically advanced cars like Teslas, an absolute ton of data is processed right inside the vehicle. This includes all the advanced safety and convenience features that use cameras and sensors all over the car. Most of this data never really leaves the vehicle. Instead, it's all computed right there at the edge, with only the distilled data being sent back to the mothership. Okay, so that covers edge computing, but what is fog computing? To be completely honest with you, this is kind of splitting hairs. It feels like another buzzword that could generate some revenue, so it got jammed into the tech terms glossary. Very simply, fog computing is somewhere between edge computing and traditional cloud computing, hence fog. The best example I could give would be a company network with a bunch of different sensors, like motion sensors and smart lights and monitoring and etc. All these devices may not provide much computing themselves, and even tying them together at the edge might be too close to get the big picture. By taking one step out and bringing the data together on the network, but not as far as the data center, you might be able to get some more valuable data and make decisions without consuming as much general internet bandwidth. Another common place where you hear the word edge come into play is with edge networking. The term generally applies the same concepts, but is slightly different than your traditional edge computing. Edge networking is often related to content delivery networks that will physically distribute caching servers like around the world. With edge networking, when you make a request, for example, to watch this video, you're probably not getting the video served to you from the original source. It's way more likely that you're getting a cached copy of the video from a caching server somewhere at the network's edge. Over the last few years, edge networking has gotten more and more advanced. Services like Cloudflare now offer way more than just caching at the edge. They now offer, with some configuration, the ability to distribute parts of your web logic out to the edge as well. This takes a strain off your poor server that in the past would have to serve all of the dynamic content on its own. Another edge provider that many developers are familiar with is Vercel. Vercel can take an application written in the popular Meta framework Next.js and distribute it to the edge network to make your website highly available and distributed with very little extra work. So, is this all just hype? Well, yes and no, I suppose. All the edge stuff is certainly real and useful tech. If you lump it all together and forget what all the hyped up tech lingo is, it's really just a way of saying move the compute power closer to the user. Getting caught up in the technical definition seems a little silly when in reality it's just best to think of the optimal way to make a great experience for your end user. So if you're ever asked about edge technology, just think distributed. Gone are the days of the simple server sitting on a rack serving an entire experience. To truly compete, you need to make things fast and efficient. To do that, you probably need to use, or are already using, the edge.